Breakfast Show today. 6:33 on your drive in this morning. You know, this Beyond Meat company has gone public, and it's big, kind of big news here lately. Just went IPO on this. JP Morgan came out and says, this is a $100 billion industry, and Beyond Meat is scheduled to take a big chunk of that. Well, you know, Impossible Burger is also out into the marketplace, and they've actually got a linkage with Burger King, where you now get the Impossible Whopper, and they are rolling that out nationwide. So already Beyond Meat already has a big competition base coming in. But again, you know, success is going to bring into the markets, you know, competition. But, you know, one thing that we talk, you know, in this whole idea of, you know, plant-based protein, right, just sounds yummy, right? I know Russell's sitting there, you know, Russell's a big barbecue guy. He's a big grill guy, right? He's competed in cook-offs. He wins cook-offs. I know he's just sitting over there salivating right now. I can't wait to throw some plant-based protein on the grill, fire it up, and make
yummy.
He's ready to roll. Right, Russell. I mean,
making me hungry.
He makes these really great things. They're called Big Bens, and it's chicken and jalapenos and cheese wrapped in bacon.
Oh,
yeah. Wow. There's nothing healthy about them, but they do make plant-based chicken. So you
wait a minute, plant-based chicken. What do chickens eat?
Plants.
So that's redundant,
of course. But the real question is, you know, we've had Keith Klein on the show here, you know, numerous times in the past, and we've talked about, you know, the importance of, you know, it's great to talk about money and what's happening in the economy and all that. And it's all great to have money in the bank, but if your health is not so good, you're going to spend a large chunk of your savings taking care of yourself in retirement and, you know, being in the doctors and the hospital. Not really a great way to, you know, spend your retirement being in the hospital. So, you know, we talked about the importance of, you know, eating right and exercising and I'm not talking about being in the gym every day. I'm just talking about small little things, right? And this is what we had Keith Klein on the show to talk about, you know, small changes that lead to a healthier lifestyle. And he has a very simple program, really, when it comes to eating, which is simply to look at what you eat and if the fat content should not be any more than 20% of the total calories of whatever you're eating. So if something that you're eating is 100 calories in total, then no more than 20% of those calories should come from fat. So when you look at the back of a package, it tells you calories from fat. So you take a look at total calories, 100 calories. Calories from fat should be no more than 20. I mean, it's a pretty simple math. And if you do that, you'll be surprised. You'll lose weight. You'll feel better. You'll make better eating decisions. It's a really, really simple thing. Just look at the back of a package. Eat more fruits and vegetables, like your mom tells you. But 20% of whatever you take in should not be more than 20% in fat. Okay, so it's easy math. It's easy to do, and you can make some substantive changes to the quality of your life and your health, right? And it's going to save you a ton of money down the road. Okay, so plant-based protein should solve those problems, right? I mean, obviously, if it's all from plants, it's got to be healthy for you. Let's take a look at something real quick. I did this analysis this morning because I was thinking about Russell, and it's about that time of the year. We're getting into summer. Just had Memorial Day.
Yeah.
Time to grill up some steaks, maybe some burgers on the grill.
Mm, I'm hungry.
I am getting hungry now. I wasn't hungry. Now I'm getting hungry. So Russell goes out. He throws on the grill a nice, juicy hamburger patty. Okay? A hamburger patty has 266 calories in total. 16% come from fat.
That's not bad.
Okay, so well within our guidelines of what we can eat and have a healthier lifestyle, right? Mm-hmm. So I've got 16% of my calories coming from fat. I've got 266 calories coming from my burger. Now, mind you, once you put it on the bun, you add the double things of cheese, you know, two slabs of bacon, your fat content's
avocado.
Going up. Okay, we're just talking about the burger for a moment. What you add onto that is your thing,
trouble.
Right? Yeah.
Bacon.
But that goes the same thing with anything,
well, sure.
Right?
So, sure.
So let's swap that out, and let's take a look at this new Beyond Meat patty.
So the hamburger was the 16% ratio.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So, by the way, this just sounds fantastic, by the way. What is it? What is... What is actually in a Beyond Meat burger? Pea protein isolate, expeller pressed canola oil, refined coconut oil, contains 2% or less of the following: cellulose from bamboo, potato starch, natural flavor, maltodextrin, yeast extract, salt, sunflower oil, vegetable glycerin, dried yeast. I just want to get me a big old mouthful of that. Okay, so...
Can you imagine a donut made from that?
Yeah. Here we go. Let's throw a Beyond Meat burger on the grill.
All right.
Let's whip that puppy up, throw it on a bun. Sizzle. We've got 270 calories coming out of the Beyond Meat burger versus 266 of Russell's professionally grilled hamburger.
Yes.
So got a few more calories. Not enough. Four more calories.
Sure.
No big deal. 170 calories coming from fat. Almost 60% of a Beyond Meat burger is of calories, and a Beyond Meat burger is from fat.
Really?
Well, yeah. Let's go back to the main ingredients. What are the main ingredients? Pea protein, pressed canola oil, refined coconut. Refined coconut oil is one of the fattiest oils out there.
And the way that they list the ingredients, it's in order of magnitude.
Correct.
Reducing as you go down the list.
Exactly. So, your top two ingredients in a Beyond Meat burger is oil.
Mm-hmm.
Now, not surprising, right? If you want something to taste good.
Slather it in oil, baby.
Yeah, wrap it in bacon.
Lard.
It's fat, right? The more fat you have, the better it tastes.
Yeah.
Right? So that's why we wrap everything in bacon. It's because we want it to taste better. You can take...
anything.
You can take Brussels sprouts, wrap them puppies in bacon. You got something going.
I've had that before.
I know. They're actually pretty good. But again.
Yeah.
Again.
And when you grill them, they're even better.
Exactly. Again. Wrap them in fat. Deep fry them. Wrap them in bacon. Anything tastes good. It's interesting. I mean, the whole idea is we're supposed to be doing things that are healthier. And look, I think the Beyond Meat thing is fine. The Impossible Burger is fine. I like veggie burgers. I go to Beck's Prime. I think they have one of the best veggie burgers in Houston. So if I'm trying to stay on my, when I'm really cranking down on my diet, which is the majority of the time, because my wife says so, I go and I'll get a veggie burger at Beck's Prime. One of the best in Houston. It tastes great. 12% calories from fat. So, you really have to watch. Just because something is labeled as plant-based protein, of course, the website is, we're going to save the planet, right? We're going to eliminate the usage of cows so we can take more farmland to raise plants to make plant-based protein. Well, you know where we're going, but the problem is it's not healthy, right? It's not a healthy option. And the goal of eating right and the goal of dieting and the goal of making decisions is to have better health and longevity long-term, so that, obesity is one of the biggest problems we have in the U.S. today. It's one of the biggest drags on retirement finances. See, this all comes back to money, which is that simply... the average person going, or the average couple, when they go into retirement, they're going to spend an excess of $350,000 taking care of their health in retirement because we are living longer and not taking care of ourselves. So it's important that just because somebody labels something cool and neat and it's coming out that, it's a public offering, you got to really understand what it is that you're consuming, because it's not always that healthy for you. Now, here's the other interesting part of this, and when we come back from the break, we'll talk about it, is that there's a very interesting issue coming up, speaking of farming and raising plant-based proteins and these type of things, there's a very interesting issue coming up because of the issue of trade wars and how it's impacting farmers. And, of course, just recently, it was, Donald Trump came out and says, hey, we're going to help our farmers. We're going to get them financial aid of $20 or $30 billion to help offset the problem of what's happening with trade wars. We've got a record number of farmers now filing for bankruptcy because of what's happening with tariffs and trade wars, particularly soybean farmers, et cetera, because of the export-import issues. When you put a tariff on something, well, consumers go find something else that's cheaper. So basically China shifts their consumption elsewhere. We've got a drag, what's happening with farmers, but there's a very interesting offset from this that is occurring because of what happened to farmland. And we'll talk about that when we come back from the break. I'm Real Science Roberts. Don't go away.
Want a longer talk with Lance about your money? Request a personal one-on-one at lanceroberts.com.